Greetings. My name is Catherine Wilson, and I am the Director of Music and Worship here at Decatur First United Methodist Church. On behalf of our clergy and staff, we welcome you to this, our first ever online service of readings and carols. Although Advent is very different this year, we are glad that you've joined us, and we hope this service, offered both from home and from the church, will bring you a little bit of peace and joy this year. We also would like to invite you to our other online offerings. We have Sunday morning streamings at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Facebook and YouTube, as well as on Vimeo. We also will have Christmas Eve online at 4:30 and 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in those same locations. We hope you will join us whenever and however you can. May the peace of Christ be with you, and let us worship.
Please pray with me. Holy God, God of the small and seemingly insignificant, God of the poor and oppressed, God of timid teenagers, tiny towns, obscure stables, and unimportant people, may we recognize that your love and your light shines within timid teenagers and those seemingly small and insignificant places. And may we live and love in the hope that your light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not and will not overcome it. Amen. Now hear these words from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who have lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to the Galilean village of Nazareth to a virgin engaged to be married to a man descended from David. His name was Joseph, and the virgin's name, Mary. Upon entering, Gabriel greeted her. "Good morning. You're beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you." She was thoroughly shaken, wondering what was behind a greeting like that. But the angel assured her, "Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son and call his name Jesus. He will be great, be called Son of the Highest. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will rule Jacob's house forever. No end ever to his kingdom." Mary said to the angel, "But how? I've never slept with a man." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Highest hover over you. Therefore, the child you bring to birth will be called Holy, Son of God. And did you know that your cousin Elizabeth conceived a son, old as she is? Everyone called her barren, and here she is, 6 months pregnant. Nothing you see is impossible with God." And Mary said, "Yes, I see it all now. I'm the Lord's maid, ready to serve. Let it be with me just as you say." Then the angel left her. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Prepare the way of the Lord.
There was a time, an Advent poem. There was a time when there was no time, when darkness reigned as king, when a formless void was all that there was in the nothingness of eternity, when it was night. But over the void and over the night, love watched. There was a time when time began. It began when love spoke. Time began for light and life, for splendor and grandeur. Time began for seas and mountains, for flowers and birds. Time began for the valleys to ring with the songs of life and for the wilderness to echo with the wailing wind and howling of animals. And over the earth, love watched. There was a time when time began to be recorded, a time when love breathed and a new creature came to life. A new creature so special that it was in the image and likeness of love who is God. And so man was born, and the dawn of a new day shone on the world. And over man, love watched. But there came a time when the new day faded, a time when man who was like God tried to be God, a time when the creature challenged the creator, a time when man preferred death to life and darkness to light. And so the new day settled into twilight, and over the darkness, love watched. There was a time of waiting in the darkness, a time when man waited in the shadows and all creation groaned with sadness. There was waiting for love to speak again, for love to breathe again. And kings and nations and empires rose and faded in the shadows, and love waited and watched. Finally, there came a time when love spoke again, a word from eternity, a word spoken to a girl who belonged to a people not known by the world, spoken to a girl who belonged to a family not known by her people, to a girl named Mary. And all creation waited in hushed silence for the girl's answer. And Mary spoke her yes. And love watched over Mary. And so there came a time when love breathed again, when love breathed new life into Mary's yes. And a new day dawned for the world, a day when light returned to darkness, when life returned to dispel death. And so a day came when love became man. A mother bore a child, and love watched over love. A father watched his son. And lastly, there came a time when you and I became a part of that time. Now is the time that you and I wait. Now we wait to celebrate what the world waited for. And as we wait to celebrate what was at one time, we become a part of that time. A time when a new dawn and a new dream and a new creation began for man. And as a part of time, love waits and love watches over us.
Our King. A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered.
Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David.
He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child.
And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the
reading from the Gospel of Luke. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Joy. He did not wait till the world was ready, till men and nations were at peace. He came when the heavens were unsteady and prisoners cried out for release.
He did not wait for the perfect time. He came when the need was deep and great. He dined with sinners in all their grime, turned water into wine.
He did not wait till hearts were pure. In joy, he came to a tarnished world of sin and doubt. To a world like ours of anguished shame, he came, and his light would not go out.
He came to a world which did not mesh, to heal its tangles, shield its scorn. In the mystery of the Word made flesh, the Maker of the stars was born.
We cannot wait till the world is sane, to raise our songs with joyful voice. For to share our grief, to touch our pain, he came with love. Rejoice, rejoice.
Thank you. Dear friends, I gotta tell you, this service of readings and carols is exactly what my heart needs in this season. I grieve that we aren't physically together, all packed in here like we'd like to be, but we are connected through the bond of our Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm so grateful for all those who've participated to put this service together. It has been an enormous amount of work. And so I'm grateful for Catherine Wilson and the rest of our music staff and our choirs, our ensembles, and all those who participated. Thank you. And so now I send you forth to go out into the world to share the love of God with everyone you meet, to love extravagantly, give generously, serve faithfully, live simply, pray daily, and leave everything else to God. God is with us now and will be with us forever. Thanks be to God.